उनका वेलकम कीजिए, पहले तो शुरू कर लीजिए, बाकी अदर्स
तो
बाद।
वेलकम टू दिस लेक्चर ऑफ टुडेज ऑन इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट टू एनवायरमेंटल सैनिटेशन। एज ऑल वी नो दिस इज अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक नाउअडेज ड्यू टू क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड वेस्ट, हाउ द वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट हेल्प्स अस टू कीप द एनवायरमेंट क्लीन। एंड ड्यू टू इफ वी डोंट डू दिस then we know that all types of diseases and environment deterioration is done by not doing the waste management. So all the publics, all the stakeholders nowadays giving all importance to this important topic, that is a waste management. And due to the disposal of waste in right manner, it helps to keep the diseases away, as the mosquitoes and other things are not properly bred. So on this day, on this occasion, as we all are celebrating the cleanliness month all the way from 2nd October to 30th October, and we are doing different kind of activities under RC Chandigarh, as under the guidance ship of our honorable vice chancellor sahab and our senior regional director Dr. Bhanu Pratap Singh, who is present at this occasion. I am thankful to him, and at the same time I am thankful to our key speaker today, Dr. Hari Shankar ji, who is the manager at the reputed firm in Jammu and doing a lot of work in the waste management, disposal of waste management and its importance. So I request Dr. Bhanu ji to please welcome our guest and others.
Thank you. Murul ji. Hari Shankar ji hain?
Haan ji sir, bilkul available hai. Good afternoon all.
Yeah, good afternoon. Hari Shankar ji, welcome for today's lecture, and I hope your lecture will definitely benefit us, and we will be we will learn many things by your lecture. Me and my team, in advance, thank you very much. So now I will turn for you. So please share your views on the today's topic. Hari Shankar.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, RC Chandigarh, for organizing this webinar on this topic of
your voice is not coming properly.
One second. Am I audible?
Very slow at my side. तेजपाल जी, आर यू ऑडिबल?
जी जी हरी, एक बार अपना वीडियो भी चेक करा दे मुझे।
ओके
हाँ ओके, प्लीज एक बार थोड़ा सा बोलेंगे तो ऑडियो भी टेस्टिंग हो जाएगी प्लीज, और कैमरा सेट कर लो।
ओके ओके ओके, राइट राइट।
शायद आप खुले रूम में बैठे हैं, आवाज गूंज रही है, ऐसा हो सकता है। एक दो लाइन बोल दें जिससे कि ऑडियो टेस्टिंग हो जाए।
हेलो
जी,
इज इट क्लियर?
बोलना पड़ेगा सर आपको थोड़ी देर तक, उससे फिर पता लगेगा आवाज की।
ओके राइट राइट राइट। थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर मैनेजिंग योर टाइम दिस वेबिनार बेसिकली ऑन एनवायरमेंट सैनिटेशन। So we are here to discuss basically on waste management and its impact on environment, and basically effect on human and animal health for the by this waste generating heavy quantity of waste, industrial waste, municipal waste, and other waste. Is voice clear now?
जी सर, आपकी आवाज़ क्लियर है।
सॉरी,
ठीक है, ऑडियो ठीक है, प्लीज आप अपने वीडियो को भी अगर ऑन कर लेगी तो मेरे को लगता है कि वीडियो या तो फिर नेट कम है आपके यहाँ पे।
वन सेकेंड, मैं एक प्रेजेंटेशन कर रहा हूँ शेयर।
ओके,
इज इट विजिबल?
यस।
ओके, सो बेसिकली द टुडे टॉपिक इज the importance of waste management to environment sanitation. So we are on to discuss the waste management impact on environment. So before starting this webinar, if anyone having any query, you can ask anytime during the presentation or after the completion of presentation. So I'm starting this. So basically, why we are discussing about environment sanitation in waste and on waste management. So the first slide is to why this requirement is came us to us. The rules, the regulation, the guidelines, government instructions for the waste management. So these are started from around 50 years before. So first is to discuss it. The Great Smog of London. It was occurred in 1952 from 5 December 1952 to 9 December 1952. During this tenure of 5 days, there was a huge smoke and fog. So basically, smog, the combination of smoke and fog is called smog. So smog is layer is prepared by the burning of coals and the emission of fuel. So during these 5 days in England, around 10,000 people were dying because the issue was to inhalation of air, because oxygen presence was very little there and so much SO2 was available there. So because of this heavy air pollution, many people were dying. In on government record, there was more than 10,000 people who had died due to this. So this caused the due to air pollution. So after this, in India, 1981 Air Act was implemented. Due to this, basically the major tragedy was the Great Smog of London. After that, we are moving to second main disease that was caused by methyl mercury. In 1956, it was identified in Japan. The city name is Minamata. So in Japan, there is a city name called Minamata city. So there was a Minamata Bay like, and there is a river, Minamata River. So due to this heavy pollution, the bay and the river was polluted. So due to this, around more than 15,000 people were died due to nervous system damage. So nervous system, our nervous system is damaged. We cannot basically sense the properly. We cannot respond properly. So their body was crippled. Many people were died. It was affected large population. So this was caused due to methyl mercury. The company was releasing methyl mercury was Cizo Corporation. Cizo Corporation was producing aldehyde using methyl mercury, and the waste was released into river and way of Minamata. So this was caused due to polluted water. So in India, 1974 Water Act was implemented. After that, the Love Canal tragedy was occurred at New York. It was due to because in 1880, a company was planning to construct a hydro project for the electricity requirement at Niagara Falls. This is situated in boundary of US and Canada. So because due to some reasons and due to financial slowdown, the project was not constructed, and a canal was constructed for this project. So that canal was sold to a company called Hooker Chemicals. कुकर कैन कस्टम अराउंड 20,000 हजार्डस वेस्ट इन दिस कैनाल. सो दिस कैनाल वाज बेसिकली टोटली फिल्ड विद हजार्डस वेस्ट. दिस हजार्डस वेस्ट वर कंपैक्टेड एंड एबव द हजार्डस वेस्ट अ सॉइल लेयर वाज प्लेस्ड. सो आफ्टर सम टाइम the school board, basically the Niagara Falls school board was there in New York. So government, this was a government company, so they purchased that land and constructed a school building there. So after some time this hazardous waste released in the groundwater and many people were basically suffered from cancer and other diseases. So this was occurred due to dumping of hazardous waste, heavy quantity of hazardous waste illegally. And the last one is 1984, 2 December 1984, Bhopal gas tragedy. Most of us are aware with this. So this was occurred due to methyl isocyanate released in the air, and as per record, around 15,000 plus people were died. And other than that genetic diseases and the effect of that incident is affects us to this current. Basically, currently we are also suffering some small level. So इस पूरे स्लाइड में मैं आपको एक ब्रीफिंग कर लेता हूँ सभी को, अगर कुछ मिसिंग है तो. फर्स्ट है ग्रेट स्मोक ऑफ लंदन. यहाँ पे एयर पोल्यूशन हुआ था, काफ़ी ज़्यादा हुआ था, उसकी वजह से काफ़ी लोगों को प्रॉब्लम हुई थी. जैसे कि अभी आप पिछले दो साल में दिल्ली में देख रहे होंगे, वहाँ पे इतनी पोल्यूशन हो जाता कि हम किसी बहुत 50 मीटर 60 मीटर डिस्टेंस तक देख नहीं सकते, इतना ज़्यादा पोल्यूशन हो जाता है. बट जो इंग्लैंड में हुआ था, लंदन में हुआ था,
माननीय हरि जी आपकी जो पीपीटी है एक बार अगर उसको भी चेंज कर दें तो बहुत अच्छा रहेगा.
चेंज मीन्स
नेक्स्ट स्लाइड शायद अभी हुई नहीं है.
नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में इसके बारे में नहीं है, नेक्स्ट टाइम कुछ और होगा.
ओके ओके, प्लीज 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 कंटिन्यू.
मैं सिंपली एक्सप्लेन कर देता हूं, है ना. सो किसी को क्वेरी होती है तो आस्क, यू कैन आस्क, है ना. सो बेसिकली इस जो अभी पीपीटी शो कर रही है इसमें सिंपली मीन्स ये है कि जो भी पोल्यूशन के इंसिडेंट्स हुए हैं, ट्रेजेडी हुई है, उनकी वजह से गवर्नमेंट को लॉ बनाने के लिए फोर्स किया है इन इंसिडेंट्स ने, ट्रेजेडी ने. और दैट्स द रीजन बेसिकली दो जो करंट में अभी लॉ हमारे पास है, लाइक सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट रूल्स 2016, ई-वेस्ट रूल्स 2016, हजार्डस वेस्ट रूल्स, दीज रूल्स आर फॉर्म्ड ड्यू टू दीज इंसिडेंट्स बेसिकली. सो लंदन में स्मोक एयर पोल्यूशन की वजह से हुआ था, मिनीमाटा डिजीज वाटर पोल्यूशन की वजह से हुआ था, एंड लव कैनाल हजार्डस वेस्ट डंपिंग की प्रॉब्लम की वजह से हुआ था, भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी में बेसिकली केमिकल रिलीज की वजह से हुआ था. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड है वेस्ट जनरेशन सिनेरियो इन इंडिया. सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट वेस्ट. सो बेसिकली करंटली वी आर प्रोड्यूसिंग अराउंड 1.5 लाख टन म्युनिसिपल सॉलिड वेस्ट पर डे. This is very huge quantity. We are not having infrastructure to treat this waste, to handle this waste. Due to this, around 70% waste is dumped in illegal landfills. Illegal landfill means there is no scientific construction, there is no liner laying, only waste is dumped into open area. By this waste leak, basically water percolating from waste called leachate. Leachate is going to underground water and it is polluting basically groundwater. By groundwater, by soil, by air. So surrounding area is being polluted and many acres of our land is basically polluting. So this slide is to project our current waste generation. Like in other than municipal waste, we are producing around 75 lakh ton plastic waste per year, 32 lakh ton e-waste per year, and hazardous waste we are generating around 70 lakh ton per year. This data is from 2021. current challenges, what are the challenges we are facing in waste management in India? So this basically they are still increasing waste quantity. First is increasing waste quantity. We are generating huge quantity, very huge quantity, and we are not having infrastructure, handling machinery, skilled manpower to handle this waste. So first reason is to challenge is heavy quantity generation. As per population, around 0.5 to 0.6 kg per capita is generation. Per capita means single person, the waste generating single by single person per day. So this is called per capita generation. So by increasing population, the waste quantity also increasing. So first reason is to challenge heavy quantity, and we are not having infrastructure to handle this waste. Improper waste segregation. Everyone know that we are not throwing waste in dry and wet manner. We are mixing all the waste and we are throwing in dustbin. So because dry waste having polythene, paper and rubber, this type of material can be used for the incineration in co-processing cement industries. But because we are mixing vegetables, so this material causing wet moisture is increasing, and whole material is not suitable for any use. We again need to segregate. During segregation, we need lots of energy, and after segregation, moisture effect is available in the dry waste. So we cannot use directly this waste. If we can segregate dry and wet, it will be very, very helpful for the organization working for handling this waste, treatment, disposal, recycling, anywhere. Other is like infrastructure, as I told that as per quantity generation, we are not having infrastructure. Due to this, many quantity of around 70% of waste is going to landfill, and scientifically and non-scientific landfill. In indicate collection service, we are not having 100% collection service. We are currently collecting 90% of waste, 10% waste is still remain in ground. So this is choking our drains, our surrounding areas also polluting. So due to inadequate collection service, landfill are overloaded because heavy quantities generating public awareness and behavior. Public awareness and behavior like us, we are not basically doing our duty for the waste handling, waste disposal, waste starting. Regulatory compliance, basically we are having lots of rules, regulation, guidelines, but these guidelines are 100% not implementing on ground. Due to this, the waste challenge is increasing in India. High cost is plant installation, operation cost is very high, and for this handling, government is providing a very less subsidy. So that is called tipping fees. Tipping fees are very less due to this. Waste management are not properly being done. Political issues are already available. So now the topic introduction basically. Sanitation means hygiene condition. Basically the condition is clean, disease free. That is called basically sanitation. Hygiene condition is shall be maintained. In sanitation means that the hygiene condition to be maintained. Basically, the practice is to prevent human and animal from disease by providing clean environment. This is called sanitation, environment sanitation. Waste is unwanted, unusable, worthless, like the material which we are not basically required for them. Something like that is called waste. If something is not usable for me, it is waste for me. It can be usable for others, but for me it is waste. So basically waste is unwanted, unusable material. It is worthless basically. The management means the handling for the waste from inception to disposal. From generation to disposal, every action is called management. These are basically waste management hierarchy. So first is to reduce. फर्स्ट एक्शन शुड बी रिड्यूस्ड इफ वी कैन मिनिमाइज द जनरेशन ऑफ वेस्ट इट शैल बी फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी सेकेंड इज रियूज इफ वी कैन नॉट रिड्यूस वी कैन रियूज सम मटेरियल्स वी कैन रियूज सो वी शैल ट्राई टू रियूज आफ्टर दैट इफ इट कान बी रियूज इट शैल बी गिवन टू रिसाइकलर इट शैल बी रिसाइकल If it cannot be recycled, then it can be used for the recovery of materials. Like if a bottle is containing a metal cap, so metal can be recycled separately, recovered, and plastic can be recycled for recovery of the materials. Last one is disposal. Regulatory framework basically the guidelines, the rules, guidelines by Government of India. First was Water Prevention and Control Act 1974, Air Act 1981, Environment Protection Act was implemented in 1986, Hazardous Rules first time was implemented in 1989, the current latest version is 2016. Biomedical waste was implemented 1998 first time. The latest version is 2016. Solid waste management is basically framed for municipal solid waste management. It was first introduced in 2000 and the latest version is 2016. Plastic waste management implemented in 2011. The latest in 2016. E-waste management rules were implemented in 2016. So, what are the benefits of proper waste management? First is reduction in pollution. If we can properly manage the waste, the pollution level can be controlled and hygiene condition can be increased. Second one is conservation of natural habitats. If we can properly manage, we will not throw the waste in a open area and natural habitats will be conserved. Next is mitigation of greenhouse gases. Everyone know that landfills emitting greenhouse gases. So if we can properly manage waste, greenhouse gases can be reduced. Resource conservation. If properly managed, every waste has a value. If we can control the waste, we can properly manage the waste, we can collect that energy, that value from waste. So resource conservation can be also possible. Energy recovery by many types of waste management, like waste to energy. If you think waste to energy, so there is waste material used for the energy generation. Power plant, waste to energy power plants are currently running in Delhi, Hyderabad, Pune, and many other locations. So energy can also be recovered. Reduction in visual pollution, long-term environment sustainability, promotion of sustainable development. Basically, the development, sustainable development is our first priority. To grow our population without affecting the resources for upcoming generations. That is called sustainable development. So, hazardous waste management rules introduced in 2016. So, basic major features are hazardous waste management rules are explained here. First is classification. Hazardous waste can be classified by CRIT criteria. CRIT means corrosive, R means reactive, I means ignitable, and T means toxic. Basically, four criteria are available for classification of hazardous waste. Second is storage and labeling. As per Form 8 of Hazardous Waste Rule 2016, every waste bag shall be labeled with company name, type of waste, quantity of waste. This is required during handling, treatment, disposal, and waste cannot mix with other industry. So this labeling and storage shall be properly. Storage cannot exceed more than 90 days. Third is transportation. Transportation is basically the guidelines to transport the hazardous waste from generator to operator. There is many instructions in guidelines like vehicle shall be used in blue color and it shall be having means and hazardous waste on the container. Vehicle shall have GPS enabled, having a first aid box, having first firefighting cylinders. So the transportation guidelines having this type of details. Next is treatment and disposal. The waste received at the facility shall be tested. According to testing, it is required to treatment. So chemicals mixed with this hazardous waste to stabilize it. After stabilization, again it is tested. After confirmation that properly treatment is done, it is going for the landfill and or incineration. Last is compliance. Basically, many guidelines shall be followed by operator. So all the guidelines following is required under the compliance. This is pathway for hazardous waste management. First comprehension is sample collected from industry generating hazardous waste is tested for comprehensive analysis. After comprehensive analysis, the waste acceptance criteria is prepared, means what to do with this waste, like either landfilling or incineration or treatment. So that will be confirmed by acceptance criteria. After acceptance criteria, decision confirmed like landfilling, incineration or treatment. So after that, collection is done. Waste collected from industry and manifest systems have been followed. Manifest system means there is a tracking form called manifest. Manifests are having 7 copies: white, yellow, pink, orange, green, blue, gray. 7 copies are used for the collection of hazardous waste. So 2 copies are given to generator, 1 copy is transporter, 1 copy is operator, and after treatment, 1 copy is given to pollution control board, 1 is given to generator of waste. So after when waste receiving, a sample is collected, fingerprint analysis done. Fingerprint analysis shall be merged with comprehensive analysis for the confirmation of waste. After that confirmation, the waste is going for the landfilling, treatment or incineration. So this is complete process for the hazardous waste management. Next is solid waste management rules. This is framed for municipal solid waste management. So first is segregation, dry bed and domestic hazardous waste. Basically there is 3 category for the segregation. Door-to-door collection. Door-to-door collection shall be properly done with this with the operator of the CMT service, collection transportation service. Setting up material recovery facility. The material having value shall be recovered at material recovery facility. Next is EPR, extended producer responsibility. It is basically framed for the plastic product producing industries. So the industry producing plastic shall be responsible for the management of same quantity of plastic waste. Next is sanitary landfill. The waste in the disposed in the landfill. Next, waste to energy. As I said, waste material used for the incineration basically burn at high temperature and electricity produced by waste to energy plant. Next is public awareness and education. It is necessary integration with Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Currently we are operating with Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, so all cities ranking prepared on the basis of cleanliness. So Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is working for the cleanliness of cities. Compliance and penalties. So if any company or any municipality is not properly doing waste management, handling of municipal solid waste, it can be penalized by NGT. Monitoring and reporting, promoting sustainable technology, promoting research and innovation. Many things are still need to be find out, like emission of gases. We are treating emission in from incinerator, but some gases are still are known. So research and innovation is required for the identification of that gases. Next is municipal solid waste diagram. So this diagram is showing like from start gate waste, is it organic or not? If organic, yes, then it containing high energy. High energy, then If high energy, then it will go for biofuel. If it not having high energy, it will go for organic fertilizer. If it is inorganic waste, it can be reusable or recyclable. If reusable, it will be goes for the again use. Recyclable, it will go for recycling agency. If it is neither reusable nor recyclable, then it will go to landfilling. This flow diagram is for the organic fertilizer. So the municipal waste having kitchen waste, vegetable materials and organic material. That organic material is used for the production of city compost. So this process is showing that first material, organic material received, stockpiled, prepared for excess leachate removal. After that, windrows formation and turning is required. After around 1 month turning, the waste is goes to maturation. In the maturation, it is decomposed again and finally pass from the two terminals. First is 25 mm and 4 is final, basically final shall be 4 mm, and 25 mm can be changed for 36 mm, 40 mm, or 20 mm. It can be changed, but final basic, because final product shall be below 4 mm, so large terminal shall be 4 mm screen. After it, the stoner is used for the separation of glass, stone, heavy dust, light dust, sand. Because municipal waste having glass and glass is broken down in small piece, it can be come to our final compost and it will be harmful for us during application. So it shall be removed during destoner. This is biomedical waste management tools. So basically we are having four colors of dust. Yellow is for the human anatomical waste, like infectious waste. Any body part, any discarded medicine is basically disposed in yellow color dustbin, and it is basically the material in yellow color dustbin shall be incinerated. So after incineration, the ash goes to hazardous waste. Red color is used for the plastic waste. So plastic metal, bottles waste, first is autoclave. Then it goes to recycling agency for the recycling purpose. White color is used for the sharp materials like needle, syringe. The syringe or needles is basically thrown in the white color container. And last is blue. The blue color is container is used for the glassware material, discarding the glass material. These glass material are again sanitized, autoclaved, and goes for the recycling agency. Next is plastic waste management program. Basically, plastic waste management diagram is having new technology, old war, because single use plastic does not have a recycling value. So new technology, basically pyrolysis is used at in absence of oxygen. High temperature is used for the melting and polishing, and liquid fuel is recovered from that. Tar material is used for the road, and it can be used for the co-processing in cement industries. Next is e-waste management project. So e-waste management is first is collection, second storage, then segregation. After segregation, if any material having refurbished value, it can be goes to refurbishing. If not having, it goes to dismantling. After dismantling, the hazardous waste is generating. The hazardous waste goes to hazardous waste landfill, and the metals goes to precious metal recovery facility. Opportunities to improve waste management practice. So first is to source segregation. If we can implement 100% source segregation, 90% problem will be sorted out, because the whole waste shall be passed from single system. If we can store it in dry and wet, dry waste can be directly used for the co-processing or waste to energy plants, and wet waste can be directly used for the production of city compost. Second is public awareness and education. Public shall be aware for the handling of waste. Community waste program, 2016 rules for the solid waste management state that community shall have a common composting facility to manage the organic waste generating in that community or that society. So these materials shall be used in composting, and compost materials shall be used in the gardening. So next is waste collection infrastructure shall be improved. Waste energy plant shall also be increased. Extended producer responsibility is still 100% not implemented, so it shall be implemented. Recycler shall be incentivized for high recycling facility. Waste audit and waste data management, it is required to improve our system or our working style and waste management practice. Research innovation are required for many materials handling and newer technology implementation. Regulatory enforcement, basically rules shall be still stringent for the proper handling, treatment and disposal of waste. Circular economy means that waste shall be recycled for and reused. Circular economy, so itself it can also improve our system in waste management. And last is government initiative. Government initiative can be like subsidy system in composting, in recycling and in sustainable management of waste. Yes, that's all. Thank you.
थैंक यू वेरी मच डॉक्टर हरिशंकर जी, आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद फॉर दिस वंडरफुल एंड लर्निंगफुल सेशन। और जो हमारी जो कंपेनियन थ्री, जिसमें या तो किसी चीज़ को यूज कीजिए या डिस्पोज कीजिए, और हमें लगता है कि आपका जो
सर आपकी आवाज,
हाँ वो कनेक्शन लॉस हुआ था थोड़ी देर के लिए।
ओके जी सर,
बहुत कुछ नहीं कहना है, बस इतना ही कहना है कि आज का जो सेशन है हमारे लिए सबके लिए काफ़ी लर्निंगफुल है, और निसंदेह जो हमारे जो कंपेनियन 3.0 चल रहा है, इसमें हमें बहुत सारी चीज़ों को, जो चीज़ ठीक हो सकती हैं, जो चीज़ प्रॉपरली यूज की जा सकती हैं उन्हें यूज करेंगे हम, और जो चीज़ नहीं उनको डिस्पोज ऑफ करके या रिसाइकिल करके, तो उससे आपके से हमें काफ़ी मदद मिलेगी। बाकी अगर किन्हीं को कुछ पूछना है तो हरिशंकर हैं, वो अपना डाउट, अपनी क्वेरी आप पूछ सकते हैं। फ्लोर इज ओपन फॉर ऑल।
गुप्त साहब, मैं एक अभिनंदन करना चाहेंगे हम रिले सेंटर दिल्ली को और इग्नो रिले सेंटर भोपाल का। प्लीज सर, वो भी हमारे बीच में है, तो हम दिल की गहराइयों से उनका भी अभिनंदन करते हैं।
सही हुआ भाई,
सर माइक ऑन कर लीजिए प्लीज।
यस, मैं देख पा रहा हूँ रीजनल सेंटर दिल्ली 2 और रीजनल सेंटर भोपाल भी हमारे साथ जुड़े। आपका भी सर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। नूरुल जी,
डॉक्टर जी सर,
वोट ऑफ थैंक्स दे दीजिए।
इफ डॉक्टर सविता इज देयर शी कैन डू दिस, बट अदरवाइज आई विल डू इट।
सविता जी आप सुन पा रहे हैं? डॉक्टर सविता,
यस सर,
Dr. Savita, please present a vote of thanks.
Thank you very much, Nuruji, for giving me this opportunity to present a vote of thanks. आज का सेशन बहुत ही अच्छा था और इसको ऑर्गेनाइज करने के लिए मैं अपने जूनियर डायरेक्टर सर डॉक्टर भानु प्रताप सिंह जी का बहुत ज़्यादा अभिनंदन करती हूँ कि उन्होंने हमें इस बारे में इतनी अच्छी जानकारी प्रदान करने के लिए इतने अच्छे एक योग्य जो है व्यक्ति को आमंत्रित किया ताकि हमें इसके बारे में अच्छी जानकारी मिल सके। और मैं अभिनंदन करना चाहूँगी, धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगी हमारे रीनल सेंटर डेली टू और रीनल सेंटर भोपाल का जिन्होंने जो है हमारे इस वेबिनार को ज्वाइन किया। थैंक यू वेरी मच। और मैं जो है हमारे जो आज के हमारे मुख्य वक्ता हैं हरिशंकर जी, उनका भी मैं बहुत बहुत अभिनंदन करना चाहूँगी कि उन्होंने आज जो है बहुत ही अच्छा वक्तव्य जो है वो यहाँ पे दिया है इसके बारे में। क्योंकि आज जो ये सैनिटेशन के बारे में जो ये समस्या है, वेस्ट की जो समस्या है, ये बहुत बड़ी समस्या है और जितनी जल्दी हम लोग इसका निवारण करेंगे उतना ही ज़्यादा अच्छा होगा कि हमारी आगे की पीढ़ियों के लिए हम एक अच्छा और स्वस्थ वातावरण जो है वो छोड़कर जाएंगे। क्योंकि ये बहुत ज़रूरी है, अभी हमारे रिसोर्सेज हैं वो सारे अभी ख़त्म हो रहे हैं, जो भी हमारे पास रिसोर्सेज बचे हुए हैं उनका हमें जुडिशली है उपयोग करना है। इसके साथ साथ ही जो हमारा जो हम पर्यावरण है उसको भी हमें जो है बचा के रखना है, संभाल के रखना है ताकि आगे वाली पीढ़ियां भी जो है वो स्वस्थ जीवन जो है वो जी सकें। पृथ्वी पर हमारा सबका जो है मानव जाति का और अन्य सभी जीव जंतुओं के लिए भी वो रहने के लायक हो, तो ये सब हमें ध्यान रखना है। और किस तरह से हम वेस्ट को सेग्रीगेट कर सकते हैं, किस तरह से हम उसका जो है वो प्रॉपर डिस्पोज ऑफ कर सकते हैं, ये सारी जानकारी आज जो हमें दी है सर ने, हरिशंकर जी ने बहुत ही अच्छे से दी है। इसके लिए मैं उनका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद करती हूँ कि उन्होंने टाइम निकाला और इतनी अच्छी प्रेजेंटेशन जो है वो आज हम सबके सामने दी है। इसके साथ ही मैं क्षेत्र केंद्र चंडीगढ़ के सभी कर्मचारियों का भी धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगी जो आज इस कार्यक्रम में वेबिनार में उपस्थित हैं। और इसके अलावा हमारे क्षेत्र केंद्र के जो अंतर्गत हमारे स्टडी सेंटर्स हैं उनको भी हमने इन्विटेशन दिया था, वो भी जो है वो इसमें जो है अभी आज कुछ नहीं हो पाए हैं क्योंकि हमने उनको बोला था कि ज्वाइन कर लें बट कार्य की व्यवस्था की वजह से वो नहीं आ पाए। एक हमारे पास सोनू कुमार जर्नलिस्ट जी भी हैं जो मैं सभी भी उपस्थित लोग हैं उन सभी का धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगी कि उन्होंने जो है इस वेबिनार को ज्वाइन करके उसकी शोभा बढ़ाई। और साथ ही साथ मैं सभी से निवेदन भी करूंगी कि जो भी हमें उपयोगी बातें आज हरिशंकर जी ने बताई हैं उन सभी को हम अमल करें ताकि जितना भी ज्यादा जल्दी से जल्दी हम इस वेस्ट को जो है वो डिस्पोज ऑफ कर सकें, प्रॉपर उसका जो है वो अगर रिसाइकल हो सकता है तो उन्हें रिसाइकल करवाएं और जिसको भी जिस तरह से भी डिस्पोज ऑफ करके हम उसको खत्म कर सकते हैं, वातावरण को जो है वो साफ बनाने के लिए, स्वच्छ बनाने के लिए वो सभी कदम हम सब मिलकर उठाएं ताकि जो हमारा एक उद्देश्य है कैंपेन 3.0 का उसको हम जो वो हासिल कर सके, यही हमारे क्षेत्रीय केंद्र का लक्ष्य है। इसके लिए मैं सभी का धन्यवाद करना चाहूंगी और अब मैं अपने क्षेत्रीय केंद्र के वरिष्ठ निदेशक महोदय से कहूंगी कि वो वेबिनार के समापन की घोषणा करें। थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू और धन्यवाद देने वाले डॉक्टर सविता का भी धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू सर,
आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू। थैंक यू।
थैंक यू नूरुल सर।